Zainab question or questions were about, first of all, taking a loan from a company or buying something. So what Zainab is saying is there's a company that is a financing company. I go to them and I say, listen, I need to buy 1,000 tons of cement, and I don't have the money to buy it in cash. So the company says, okay, the 1,000 tons of cement would cost you 100,000 reals, for example. But because we're selling it to you in installments, we will sell it to you for 120,000 with a margin of 20,000 extra. So I said, okay, I'm fine with that. We signed the contract, they go, they finance or they purchase the 1,000 tons of cement. They have the trucks. I take the trucks. I use it in building. I sell it. I do whatever I do with it. What's the ruling on this? This is totally prohibited. Why? First of all, the actual transaction is not buying and selling cement. The actual transaction is that the company lent me 100,000 reals so that I would return it to it 120,000 reals. The cement is nothing for the company. There's no risk on the company. And therefore, the Prophet said in the hadith of Hakim ibn Hizam, the Prophet ﷺ said, لا تبع ما ليس عندك. Do not sell what you do not possess. Why? I'll tell you why. If I possess this pen, I'm the sole owner of it. There is a risk that not a single person would buy it from me, or I will not be able to sell it except with 20 or 30% below the cost price. I lost. And there is a possibility that I would sell it for double the price I gained. Now, buying and selling this commodity is halal, whether in cash or in installments, because I possess it. But when this financial institution, a bank or whatever, comes and says to a customer, we will give you 10 rials as a loan, and you have to give it back to us 12 rials. This is clear riba. Everyone knows this because it's cash in return of cash, interest over a loan. But when they come and say, you buy whatever you want, we will finance you and you will give us our percentage. People are confused. They say, okay, they are selling us. No, they're not selling you. There is no loss on them. When they finance selling the pen to me for 12 rials, where the cost is actually 10, there is no loss for them because they took the guarantees while signing the contract with me that I'm committed to buying it. So actually, I bought something they do not possess. And actually, they only lent me 10 rials in return for 12 rials back to them with the profit, and the pen has no significance, none whatsoever for them. Therefore, Zainab, going to a company, asking them to buy something for you, which is a third-party company, this is riba and not permissible.